this is actually
translate some of that into glass. I spent 2 years at the International Glass Centre and learned a lot of skills and decided that sand casting was the major way, major technique that I wanted to use. And then my mum moved to the Caribbean and I started to go there quite regularly and got very influenced by the colourfulness and the lushness of the vegetation. And again, it's a volcanic island. Amazing rock formations, structures, and I suppose somehow all these things have kind of been absorbed by me and then come out into the glass. I like with sunsets, you can look at them and every second they change. colours deepen or lighten, or shapes get denser, and it's an ever-changing thing. Within 30 seconds, you've got so many different snapshots, and I just love that dynamic, that energy, and that changingness, that everything, nothing stays the same, keeps moving and changing. This is how I came to be here, was there was a connection made between Stourbridge, where I now live, which is also a very strong glass area traditionally, and so the college that I went to, they had a connection with Frauenau, and we, as a group of us from Stourbridge, came and exhibited on two consecutive years, and it was through that I was invited to come here and do this residency. For me also, I've never worked in a factory before, only ever in individual studios, and that's different. And the glass is very different. The glass is designed for decanters and wine glasses, and it's not designed for casting. It's a very short glass, so glass cools too quickly. I've had to adapt my technique to suit this glass, so it's been technically quite challenging. I have changed my style somewhat to suit this glass. Normally I work with transparent colours, and I like to build layers and add different things into the glass so that the light travels through the pieces, but we haven't had so many transparent colours here, so most of the work has been in opaque colours. So that too is different for me. know if you get lost.
Gut. Einmal, zwei, drei. Wir gehen.
go sleepy.
Und dann einschleifen und polieren.
Yeah.
Folie. Mit der rechten Oberflächen vom Schlag. Spritzt es.
Das ist so aus.
Thank you. das gute Stück dann im Vorschein.
Von verschiedenen Scheiben und Steinen. Das ist ein sehr interessantes Stück, ist da. Wunderbar, der Schlüssel ist nur jetzt in der Flügelzeit, in der Ausbildung. Da muss man sich ja besondere Mühe geben. Und da kann natürlich mal sein, bei diesen Putzarbeiten, wie wir es da sehen, kann einmal ein Riss drin sein. Das müssen wir jetzt schauen, da wir das so hinbringen, dass man das nicht mehr sieht. Schlacht man da etwas tiefer aus und wieder einschleifen und dann zum Schluss sauber abrunden und polieren. Und der Schmetterling dann vielleicht bei einer Sammlung drin, weil ein wertvolles Stück wird. Das wäre ja schön. Ein bisschen abrunden da, das ist schon das Papier. Verschwindet der Riss allmählich, der eine Dienst ist.